Here's the slipper, and we're going to seam it together. Pull the rag hem in. Fold right sides together. And you're going to do the Kitchener stitch on this end here. Find the long strand. There it is. You're going to need your needle. Get the stitches lined up. Now we're doing the pale yellow. So you're going to go across and in. Go into the next loop. Then go into the loop that the yarn is attached to. You're going to go into the loop beside it. Make sure you get the loop. And you're going to go back through the same loop you came out earlier. Okay, go into the next loop. Then go across and back one into the same one you just came out of on the other side. Go next door, same across and into the same one. Look at it, it's going to be like at an angle. Into the next one, then across. Again, it's still at work, you're working at an angle each time. Then in, and you'll do this all the way down. Then when you get that done, you'll take the waste yarn off and then seam up the sides. Being careful not to pick up the waste yarn. It's going to get a little bit tight when you get down to the last few stitches. Just take your time. Make sure you have the loop, not the space between it. And make sure you don't take the thread you're working on, okay? You want to make sure you get the loop that the yarn is going through. You're basically recreating the stitches. just go carefully at the end, because it does get a little bit of tight. You may have to play around with a little bit to get it to come up so you can see the stitches. See, I'm going back into the one that this come out of. You might have to kind of push it up a little so you can see the where the stitches sit. Just take your time so you can find the right stitch. Excuse me. Turn it right side out. You see this, the ravel cord, you want to take that out. But remember, you tied it into a bow so it wouldn't come loose. So you have to undo that bow. There we go. First stitch always seems to tie itself into a knot. You may have to spend a little bit of time loosening it. But once you have it come through free and easy, same like that, you can go over here, pick up one. Get a little bit of a pull area and just pull it. Now if it's too tight and it hurts your hand, what you can do is take one of your tools, wrap it around the end, holding onto the thread and pull. Wrap the tool, pull. Okay, wrap your tool and pull. Now when you pull this apart, make sure each of the stitches you've stitched. And if it didn't, for some reason, just go ahead and pick it up. See, like that one didn't get stitched. So what you want to do is when you go to seam it, you want to make sure you pick up that stitch. But in the meantime, I'm going to just hang on to it like that. Now, the top, you can either let it roll down if you want, or fold it and stitch it down. And that's what I want to do. So you find how tall you want it, find the top edge, and right now I'm using a double pointed needle. Maintaining the same height, and just stitching that in. And I'll take this long piece and I'll just stitch this down by picking up each stitch. And I'll just do a simple whip stitch and close that up. Pick it up and just stitch it down that way. Make sure I pick up the same row all the way across. And I'll be back when I get those two done. We have the top folded band done. We have the bottom done. Now we need to stitch up the ends. And I'm going to use the mattress stitch with this. And that's the wrong yellow. Let's see. Well, let me use it and I'll show you. Okay, you want it longer than your piece. You need to stitch. Fold it in half and thread it. Okay, now I'm going to start from the bottom. Work my way up. Okay, you stitch it. And remember, we wanted to catch that stitch. So I'm going to go up through that stitch. And now I can take this off. Okay. Tuck those all in later. Go in and up. Go in and up. And just do this all the way down the back of the little shoe. See, that's where it went in. I'm going to go in where it came. Go in where it came. Go in and out. I'm going to just work myself all the way down. Can't even see that color. in and out, in and out, all the way up. Sorry about the background noise, we're having a thunderstorm. In where it came out. Give it a little bit of a tug and see, it disappears. Pretty much disappears. Okay, in and out. You can leave it a little loose if you want and give a nice tug. You get a bit of it stitched. See, and that closes up the gap. And that's the one I need to go up through. I'm going to keep in the same row as you work your way up. That little bit later, but here's the little booty, and I'll just trim off those threads, and there it is. Okay, well, have fun with it. I hope you make a bunch of them.